Okay, first we're going to take a white bowl and we're going to add 1 cup of all-purpose flour or maida. Then to the mix, we'll add 1/4 teaspoon of salt. Then we'll add 1/4 teaspoon of baking soda and 1/4 teaspoon of baking powder. If you don't have baking soda, you can just add 1/2 teaspoon of baking powder instead. And then next, we're going to add 3 tablespoons of cocoa powder since it's a chocolate cake. And now we're going to mix it evenly. We're going to make this chocolate cake on stovetop, so we don't need any, we need to use a oven. Once it's mixed evenly, now I'm going to make powdered sugar. Since I don't have powdered sugar at home, I'm going to take 1 cup of sugar with granular and I'm going to make powdered sugar. Okay, powdered sugar is ready. Now I'm going to take the wet milk. I'm going to take a big bowl and I'm going to crack 4 eggs. Chocolate cake, you do not need to use a whisk or a beater, so instead I'm just going to use a fork to whisk. So you'll have to whisk really well because the fluffiness and texture of your cake depends on how well you whisk the batter. So now you need to take a fork and whisk it really well. Sugar little by little. Whisk it really well so that the cake looks really fluffy and soft. Careful so as not to spill it. Always preheat the kadai or the pan, the saucepan or big pot and any non-stick vessel that you're going to use while you're making the batter. But I always prefer to do it once I'm done making the batter because I don't want it to overheat. Adding 1/2 cup of vegetable oil. Use any vegetable oil. Here I'm using sunflower oil. Okay, now I'm going to add our dry ingredients to this mixture. Mixing with your fork. Keep this together and just add the ingredients to the rice. Don't add the ingredients to the rice. Have a right texture. Thank you. vanilla cake, you can follow the same instructions as given in this video, but you can avoid the cocoa powder which is added in the beginning, and you can add vanilla essence while we are whisking the eggs. And depending on the company and brand you use, the amount of vanilla essence will also differ. Because in some cases it's really concentrated, and in others it's quite diluted. Okay, our batter is almost ready. Almost. Be sure to take a bigger bowl. In my case, I only had a bowl of this size, hence why it keeps filling slightly. The amount of batter we have we're making in this case can be used for two small cakes or one large cake. It depends on the mold that you're going to be using. So in this case, I'm using a two small baking trays, which are circular shape, or you can use any steel vessel in your house, that like steel bowls, big steel bowls. You just need to grease it really well. Greasing is a really important step. If you don't grease your baking, whatever you're using, the baking mold or whatever vessel you're using, if you do not grease it well, then the cake will not come out easy, and then it will be a headache. That is almost done. So once we're done, this is the consistency you should aim for. It's like a gooey texture. Okay, this is my baking tray or mold. Since it's really, or you can use a steel vessel like this one. So if you're using that steel vessel, you can pour the entire batter in. But since these molds are really small, I'll be making two small cakes. You can use butter or ghee and grease it well. You can use a brush or your hands. I'm going to be pouring in the batter slowly. Once you pour the batter, ensure that you lightly tap the mold on the slab so as to avoid the air bubbles. Okay, now I'm going to preheat my kadai. I'm going to keep it in high flame and pour a little bit of oil. I'm going to keep it covered with a lid for around 5 minutes. And once it's heated, I'll place a stand and then keep the batter in. Keep it close. I'll let it cook, bake in low heat for around 50 minutes, and then I'll use a knife or a toothpick and I'll poke it in the center and lift it up to check if it's cooked properly. Once we're done, I'm going to take it out using tongs, or you can use mittens. Lift it, and that's the back side of our cake. Aha, we flipped it again. So this is what our chocolate cake looks like. You should check out the inside. So I'm going to cut it to see how it looks. Take a look at how fluffy and soft the cake is. It's really well as well. Batches like two cakes. If you're using a small mold, then you can cut it into slices and then keep it in a sealed airtight container so that you can use it later. I suggest that you keep it in a fridge so that it doesn't get spoiled easily. Look at the texture and the fluffiness. And chocolate cake is ready. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe for more such videos. Hope you'll all be able to make the chocolate cake easily at home, even without an oven, beater, or a whisk. Thank you!